Hello guys, welcome to Webstyle Press. In this video, you will learn about most essential part of a web page responsiveness. So this is a form based on bootstrap 3. Obviously, it should be responsive. This form is based on a script that is the PHP HTML5 script, and its name is email with multiple attachments. I will share the link in the description if you like to have a look. So a user downloaded that script and he implemented the script along with Bootstrap 3 in his web page. When he looked at his site on mobile view, the web page was not responsive. It was looking like this. The form fields were going out of the screen. Let's find out why. This is the live website. Let's inspect this website. Open up the inspector tools. Let me bring down these tools. You can right click at the page anywhere and click inspect to open up the web inspector tools. Let me bring these down and let's toggle device toolbar. And from here, if I select iPhone 5 and this shows me perfectly responsive website. And if I change the device to iPhone 7 and you can see the website is responsive. If I click the responsive from the menu and change width of the page, you can see that page is not going to be responsive. It is being squeezed down. The grid columns are not collapsing for smaller screen. So it was looking like that it is responsive, but it is actually not responsive. The web page is merely squeezing down. So let's find out why. There's very essential thing for web page responsiveness, that is meta tag. You have to use specific meta tags to make a web page responsive. And let's view source of web page. And here you can see the viewport, meta tag with the name viewport with width 1180 and min page width and mobile optimized and content 320. This is not the proper way to use responsive meta tags. This is the wrong way. In my opinion, you should use these responsive meta tags properly. And let me show you how. This is an HTML template, and you can see two meta tags for responsiveness. One with the meta XUA compatible and content IE edge, and the second is viewport and with content width, device dash width, and with the initial scale and shrink to fit is equal to no. You have to use these tags to make a web page responsive, otherwise, the web page will not be responsive. Without these, media queries won't work. So use these meta tags in every project that you need to make responsive. So I hope you like the video. Please give it a thumb up and subscribe to the channel. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care.